One application of the dot product is computing the work that a force does displacing an object. So if some particle or object is displaced, which we represent with some vector d representing its displacement, as a result of the actions of a force, then that force did work doing that displacement. And how much work was done? What's the dot product of the force and the displacement? The dot product is a scalar, so this is just a number. Standard units for these are newtons and meters. So you could say that the unit on work is the newton meter. That's okay, but in the context of work, we usually call that the joule and just represent it with a J. So the unit here is joules. Okay, let's look at a couple examples. Suppose I stand still and I hold a 100-kilogram weight for 1 minute. Maybe I like fully extend my arm and I'm holding some weight at the end of my arm. How much work do I do? Well, actually none. I might feel a lot of pain, but I'm not doing any physical work because I'm not moving the object. There's no displacement for this object. So if I had to represent this calculation with a displacement vector, it would just be the zero vector. So overall, I did 0 joules of work. Second example, a child pulls a wagon 10 meters to the right. How much work did the child do moving that wagon? How much work did gravity do? Okay, so we have this child here and they're pulling the wagon to the right. They're exerting a force of 20 newtons. So that's the magnitude of the force they're exerting on the wagon. And they're exerting it at an angle that makes 40 degrees with the horizon. Overall, the displacement is going to be 10 meters. So we need to set up a vector dot product representing the force and the displacement. So for this child, I have enough information just based on the picture to write down the vector for the force. I have its magnitude and a unit length sense of direction. So the magnitude of the force vector needs to be 20. And then it needs to point in such a way that makes 40 degrees with the positive x-axis. So a unit length sense of direction is cosine of 40, sine of 40. So overall, 20 times cosine of 40, sine of 40 is the vector representing the force this child exerts on this wagon. Again, that's decomposing that vector into a magnitude and a unit length sense of direction. The wagon doesn't go up or down, it goes 10 units to the right. So the displacement vector is 10, 0. We take that dot product and it's a scalar. It's just gonna be 200 times cosine of 40 degrees, or if you like, that's about 153.2 joules. So that's how much work the child did. How much work did gravity do? And the answer is gravity didn't do any work because gravity didn't cause any displacement for the wagon. The displacement was entirely horizontal, not vertical. So gravity did no work. Let's look at an example where gravity is going to do some work. So suppose I have a 20-kilogram box and it slides down a 10-meter-long ramp, which is positioned at an angle of 30 degrees like drawn in the picture. And a reason why it slides down is because it's on planet Earth and there's gravity. How much work did gravity do displacing this object? This is a work problem, so we need to understand the force and the displacement. We need to have vector expressions for both of those. Let's start with the force. Again, this is just force downwards due to gravity, so mass times the acceleration constant. That's going to be 0, 20 times negative 9.8. So overall, our force due to gravity will be represented with a vector 0, negative 196. For displacement, once again, I'm going to use that principle that you can take any vector and write it as the product of its own magnitude times a unit length vector pointing in the same direction. So how far did we travel? Well, 10 meters total, but at an angle. So the length of the displacement is 10 meters, but it's not 10 meters straight to the right or anything like that. So the length of our displacement vector is going to be 10 meters. And then we need to go this direction, which actually, if I take where the object started and declare that to be the origin, then the angle we're opening up with the positive x-axis is negative 30 degrees. So our unit length vector pointing in the direction of travel would be cosine negative 30 degrees, sine negative 30 degrees. Or in other words, it's 5 squared of 3, negative 5. If you're ever not sure if you've situated the origin correctly and if you're measuring your angles correctly, just look at the signs of the x and y component. We're traveling right and down. So it makes sense that the x coordinate is positive, that's the positive direction, and the y coordinate is negative because we're going down. Okay, so the work done by gravity is going to be the dot product of the force due to gravity together with the displacement. So we take the dot product of 0, negative 196, and the vector 5 squared to 3, negative 5. The only thing that matters is how far gravity displaced it downwards. So overall, we get that gravity did 980 joules of work. In these work computations that we saw, the answer was either 0 or a positive number. The guiding principle in terms of the sign of work is that if the displacement is in mostly the same direction as the force, then the work done is positive. So this box is sliding down. Yeah, there's a horizontal component, but we don't care about that with gravity. The box is sliding down. Gravity is pulling us down. So positive work was done. If for some reason I told the story that the box slid up the ramp, then gravity would do negative work because the displacement would be in the opposite direction of the force. That concludes this look at work done by a vector moving an object. We will actually return to work much later in the course when we look at vector line integrals. So this is just our first look at this concept. Thank you for your attention.